out of the blue. Never supposed to ask an artist about the motivation of a song or the lyrics. The lyrics are like, if people think you've stolen their story. Where did it come from?
Well, it's nice of you to say that, I guess. Yeah, because it could ruin it for some people who think it's about mountain climbing.
Somewhere along the way, my hopefulness turned to sadness. Somewhere along the way, my sadness turned to bitterness.
When you're having a very bleak situation and you're not sure, you know, it's just how something very magical and positive can come out of bleakness.
How do you enjoy performing solo? This happens to a lot of established musicians.
Yeah, I love it.
Really?
I do love it, yeah. It's really fun. You know, it's nothing even against the dudes. But it's almost like the difference between touring just me or with five of me, you know, because everyone's very opinionated, so we tend to argue about, you know, what color the car is going to take it to the airport it's going to be, so... It's just more laid back for me, and I'm sure it helps in many ways musically, so I'll do both, you know.
You said before you have strong opinions. It may be healthier for everybody else if you do your own thing for a little bit, let them do their own thing.
Yeah. I never really wanted to do, you know, the solo thing. I think for me, I was happy with the Strokes. I'd kind of given my blood, sweat, and tears into the band, and so worried about the image and everything about it. And I think we just had miscommunications. I think I understand, you know, people wanted to kind of go outside that bubble.
As we sit here today, the Strokes are still an entity.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And that entity includes Julian.
Yes.
Even though you are working independently right now.
I hear it in your silence.
Even though I'm doing this solo thing, I honestly feel like I haven't slowed down the process at all. I wanted to do the Last Strokes record during the Last Strokes tour, you know, and then some people were like, we need, you know, X amount of time off, and it was like, okay. And then when we came back to do it a few years ago, everyone was doing solo records, and people seemed like, it just seemed like spiritually the band wasn't ready to just, you know, turn a new leaf on just me and my old expressions. Yeah, and even now, the record is not, you know, ready to go, and I'm like, I got a tour, hold on. I mean, it's still being worked on, so, you know, I just did some vocals, and they're going to do some stuff, and then I'll probably sing more in May, and then hopefully it'll be out in January. You don't believe me. I can tell now, look, you don't believe me.
Well, it was September, wasn't it? It was September? It was before that was the first prediction. Well, I mean...
Well, it could have been September, but I think it would have been a lot less good.
I know this is an unfair question, but who are you listening to right now? Who do you like, especially among emerging artists and young bands?
I like a lot of songs. I don't know if there's like a, you know, like a Bob Marley type, you know, just dude that I just listen to everything. There's a lot of great songs out there. I would say probably the musicians that I respect the most are probably maybe the guy from Dirty Projectors and the guy from Arctic Monkeys. Those are pretty heavy musical hitters.
Okay, cut. What do you think of making videos? I watched, obviously, all of your behind the scenes. I love the director. I love the whole post-apocalyptic theme. That was cool. Very nice clothing. The Michael Jackson throwback era clothing was good. Bar scene. Yes. What is it like you've recorded the song? You have to kind of mime it. You have to mime it for 13 takes with a dolly shot going by. It, I think you've said, it makes you sick of your own music. You will never again like that song. And what a tragedy.
That happens way before the video shoot, though.
So, in the early stages of the mix?
I think, yeah, I mean, hopefully in the future maybe I'll be, you know, quicker about it, but when you're meticulous about it and you're listening and you're fixing things, once you end up hearing the song about 300, you know, 1,000 times, it gets a little, it's like saying a word a lot. It doesn't even make sense to you. The video thing used to be weird to me, and now I'm kind of used to it. It used to be very weird.
Well, you have a theatrical side.
I guess so, yeah. Some high school plays.
Your dance moves. So, I need you to get philosophical. You're married, you're now a father, correct?
Yes.
How awesome is that?
It's very awesome.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's cool.
It is. I mean, even this morning, he was crying, he woke up,
Daddy got
in. Just staring at him crying and the tears, it's just so cute.
Oh, I know, it's a killer.
It's amazing, I'm like, did you see this?
And
he's just like in misery. Sorry, Cal.